We're live.
Hi, everybody.
I should just do my little thing over here by get my nose out of the shot, first of all. And you're going, Kim, you're running it while I'm doing some technical shit over stuff over here.
Okay. Is this in the shot or not in the shot?
No, it's in the shot.
Okay. So today, I got a request for Irish soda bread. And I cut it into two separate loaves so that it would bake faster because I had to come over here and it takes like 70 minutes if you do it all in one. So that's actually my mom's recipe that she got from my dad's mom, who was actually from Ireland. And it's, I have it memorized, I've made it so many times. It's a stick of butter, one egg, 3 tablespoons of sugar, a knife tip of baking soda, 4 teaspoons of baking powder, 4 cups flour, caraway seeds and raisins, 1 cup buttermilk. Did I say that already? And you can melt the butter or you can use softened butter. I've done it either way. And then you just put it in a blob, cut the tops, and here it is. Kylie's whispering to her mom behind the camera.
I'm trying to get this going here.
Trying to get what going?
I'm trying to share.
Kylie, why don't you come to the show with me? Because he's fucking on his phone over there.
Hey, what are you doing in the shop then?
Just checked stuff out.
You're elite.
Were you wearing that same shirt? What the heck? Oh, I see.
This is what we need right here.
Get a cutting board.
That's why it's confusing me. Okay, so. All right, so.
Ow! I also need to thank my brother for all the things and times he's made me soda bread.
Let's hear it.
It's pretty generous of him.
It'll take a lot.
Spend his Sunday mornings making me soda bread.
It'll take a long
Getting
time.
Up early.
Yeah. It'll take a long time to hear all those thank yous, so we'll just skip them and we'll cut right to the chase.
As we normally do. Looks pretty good.
The only problem with soda bread on occasion, and it's super irritating, is when you cut it and it just crumbles. See, it's beyond irritating.
I like it when you cut it and it crumbles.
However, that's not really happening with this one. Okay, who wants a piece? Me.
I do, but it's not gluten-free.
Bees, yo, you want a piece?
Oh, I can't have any.
How come, Bees?
She's on a diet.
She's on a diet. Kylie, okay, you want a piece?
I don't like soda bread.
Mm. Oh, guess it's all for me then.
Don't
Boy, it's rough.
Brother, you don't like soda bread?
No.
Are you sure?
That's okay.
Yeah, it's like bitter and like licorice. I don't like it.
More for me.
Delicious.
It's not bitter or licorice-y.
Whatever that seed is, smells
nice. Have you tasted it?
I've had a bite before, yeah.
You've had a bite before. Will you have another bite? Do you like raisins, brother?
No.
Here's what my dad says. Don't do me any favors.
You take the raisins out, dude.
I can't have any because it's...
Oh,
sorry.
My God.
I made it for you.
This is essentially all for me.
Well, you asked for it.
Nice. Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
For the rapid... expedition of my request also.
There's no point whispering over here. I have a mic right here.
Oh, cool. Awesome.
All right.
Debbie, eat your eggs.
She's whispering right over in my mic.
Trying to be helpful.
That's kind of like...
Kylie, come on here and tell us.
I'm trying to...
I'm not wearing a bra. And
share to you, Kim.
Maybe it's like when you had a... When
doesn't
you
matter
had
if
the
you're wearing a bra or not.
With the mic on.
But I caught myself just before.
Oh, it would have been so good if you didn't. That would have been viral material.
Oh,
I
think so.
Mostly just taste the butter.
That's a great review of my soda bread.
All right, Kim Joyce, this is going to your page too. I don't know. I'm going to have to like do a little.
I mostly just taste the butter.
Instructions.
Well, let me just have another bite, okay? Jeez.
Well, at least you're not puking and spitting it out.
Okay.
Yeah? Yeah. No, I actually like it.
Morning.
Ooh, there's some cleavage there, Deb.
Oops. You put the standard amount of vitamins, of raisins in there. I don't see any white raisins.
Oh, I like it.
I'm just asking.
Send it back, babe.
Yeah, send it back.
No, this is really good. I'm just asking.
There isn't normally white raisins in there.
Okay, why don't you give them the recipe, Kim?
I did.
Mommy puts white raisins in there.
No, Mom.
Mommy only puts white raisins in there if she doesn't have the black ones.
And is there cranberries in there?
No. But Amy Sapphire makes hers with not cranberries. What's the...
Cranberries.
It's not cranberries, but it's the Irish version of raisins. What are they? You know what I'm talking about, right?
It's like,
no, no, they're little. They're cranberry-y.
Like currants.
Yes.
Oh.
Amy Sapphire makes hers with currants.
I didn't put any salt pepper on that, did you? It's good.
I don't. Oh, brother. Oh. You don't
did
say
you,
that.
Did you get a close up? Let's do a close up of the soda bread. So you did. Was I just completely oblivious to you giving instructions on how to cook this?
Well, yeah, I did give the recipe, and I did say how to do it and why it was cut in half this time, etc.
All right, move it. Move it more towards you, Kimmy. There you go.
There's no comments?
I call it runaway. Yes.
Oh, you found the cat?
Mm-hmm.
Where was he?
Out front.
Oh. Go around the corner so people can see the cat.
It's a piece of swine.
Yeah. Ooh.
It's a piece of swine.
He's a little runaway.
How is he getting out?
Out there in the back.
Because if someone opens the door, he slips out.
Yeah, he totally.
And then he sneaks by the front door waiting for someone to open it so he can like run around the edge. And then he goes for like a joyride around the neighborhood.
He's pretty lethal.
We gotta be careful though, because there's coyotes.
Yeah, you stupid idiot.
Not my grandpa.
That's Hector.
It's gonna be a sad day here if that dog gets eaten for dinner.
If you're gonna
the
say
cat.
His name twice.
The cat.
If you're gonna say his name twice, you don't go Hector.
And he is a Maine Coon cat.
He's very cute.
He's very chill. And I was going to say something about him, but now I forget.
So. I got to get you a piece without stuff.
And he's a total a-hole sometimes.
Only when he escapes.
When he escapes.
Okay, so I'm just looking for the comments here. So.
Yeah, viewers have comments, huh?
And I can't even tell if we do. Let's see, do we?
No, we usually hear a sound when the comments are
on. We have one viewer.
Oh, yeah? Who?
It's us.
I don't know. It's us, Kylie says.
You can see
it's
who
probably,
it is.
It probably is us. All right, hold on.
It's my phone.
Hang on the front.
So are we going to do the apple cider donuts?
Right now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Kim, looking good.
Oh, you took my advice.
Hey, we have
to Bij and I were out this morning before any of you guys were awake.
What were you guys doing?
You know, just jacking parts off cars.
That sounds fun.
While everyone's at
drinking. That's not what I thought.
Here we go.
No, we went to Starbucks and got some coffee.
No comments.
Is there anyone watching?
No. Well, I think we are.
No, zero
viewers. No, we signed off.
We have zero viewers.
Okay.
Interesting. Yesterday we had 5 viewers.
Mommy doesn't know.
Well, that's because it's a little weak today.
Yeah.
So everyone's at like Sunday service or captain's briefing.
It's a little weak, and we didn't like. We got to do commercials. We got to post the recipes. We got to be a little more enthusiastic, which I'm not right now.
I'm enthusiastic.
That's
what
I do.
You are.
I got up early.
What's early?
I got up at 7.
No, you always
that
get up
is early.
At 7.
I don't actually always get up at 7. It's not my natural waking time.
Whenever I'm up at 7, you're up at 7.
I hope you're all enjoying how to cook apple cider donuts and soda bread.
But that's still majority of the time, so it's usually...
Yeah, but that's... Today, I have I don't want to work today because I have continuing education to do. So I was going to come over here, do this, and then go home and do my 14 hours of continuing education for stupid real estate class.
So basically what we're trying to say is, as usual, we're completely unprepared.
All right, let's
And I even have to leave in 2 minutes to go see my daughter's
performance
of her cheer routine. And this is caraway seeds, just for the heck of it. Right? This goes in the soda bread?
Yeah, Doug and I could easily put together some apple cider donuts really fast.
Okay, so my husband's going to come and be me for this episode.
Except it's like, what's that machine that spins blood?
I have two viewers now.
Do you know the machine that spins blood? What's
like
it called?
Like that blood platelet thing or whatever?
Oh, like the hospital machine?
Yeah, it spins it. What's that machine
That's
called?
Great. Well, it spins it to separate it.
The blood spinning machine?
That's disgusting. So,
like, split out the blood?
Yeah. My brother's like a salad spinner. He generally, like, drifts to the outside. Like, he started off here, and then he just drifts over there. Out of the shot. Because he wants to go eat with his phone.
Oh, I have a useful tip.
What?
For anybody that's regular watching our show and knows about my hot flashes.
Christ.
Who told me about this? Jen Anderson. This totally works. It's called Feminescence Macapause.
Yeah, I haven't heard you say that you...
Yeah, I mean, I still get them, but they cut some way down. So you take 2 in the morning and 2 at lunch. And don't take it later than that, because then you won't be able to sleep. What?
You should make your own shots.
Okay. So as well as the apple cider donuts and the Irish soda bread, we're going to be making female menopause pills today.
We are. We're gonna grind up the herbs.
It smells pretty rank. That's a maca, right? A maca, however you say
What's
it.
What's in there?
No, it's not maca. Maca smells like ground up. You know when you cut the grass? That's what maca smells
it's
like.
It's disgusting.
I think it smells good.
I think it smells good too.
All right, let's hear how to make some apple cider donuts. Someone leave.
I want to give the dogs the rest of my eggs.
This is manufactured in Peru. Oh, comment.
Oh, we got some comments.
Oh, good.
Link them. I need to get from my mom.
Who?
The menopause things.
Yeah.
Who said that?
Prue.
Hey, Prue.
All right, Prue.
They're from home.
Prue, wouldn't it be a good idea right there?
Why don't you come in the frame? They're from Whole Foods.
No, I got them on Amazon.
Let me see these.
Jen gets them at Whole Foods.
Yeah, but I'll put the link in. Hold on a sec.
And I take something that has been called the original chill pill. Which is phosphatidylserine. Phosphatidylserine downplays cortisol. Wow.
It's like nothing in here.
Oh, jeez.
My husband's all about the money.
How much you pay for this?
I'm going to tell you in a minute.
$20? $30?
The margin's huge. There's like...
$36.99.
There's potassium and macago, 1,000 milligrams. It's a root. How many? 120 capsules? $40?
Prue's saying sell them, Doug.
Yeah, Doug.
All right, there's the link, Prue.
Sell them for dogs. The dogs have menopause now.
I don't know.
Wow, boobies is in full-time menopause.
She's a full-time pig.
If I had to recognize menopause, I'd say boobies.
Yeah.
Hi, Christine Eisenman.
Hi.
She read donuts and had to stop, so chip chop, guys. Come on, do the donuts.
You gotta get me the recipe.
So,
what?
Did you bring the apple cider?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
So, we're a little bit disorganized, Christine, but we're gonna be doing donuts. At me, I have to bug out because I gotta be on course.
We're gonna do donuts, but Debbie's leaving.
I have to leave at the beginning of our show, but thanks for tuning in. And I got
this episode is not brought to you by Feminescence Macapause because I do not partake in that activity.
Hormone balance at 50, 60. And 70. You'll be there in a minute before you know it.
Woo!
Okay, so over to you guys. Doug, take my mic. And you guys going to do the donuts now?
Yeah.
All right, so make sure you tell them the ingredients and all that fun stuff.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You're welcome.
I'm just going to stretch out my shirt.
All right, so here is the recipe.
What was that?
I need a little cup you for did my just coffee. Avert your eyes.
I did.
Pretend like it's not happening.
I did.
Here. So because I used Carol's flour that has xanthan gum in it, you don't have to use xanthan gum.
Okay.
Can you save me? Can you do an Irish soda bread gluten free and save me some? What, just alongside the donuts?
Sure, I'll just spend my whole day baking.
Yeah, next time.
What do you mean next time?
Oh wait. We have the stuff to do gluten free soda bread.
No.
Oh yeah.
All right, never mind. Over to the donuts.
Yeah.
Right, I'll see
ya. Bye.
Yeah.
But I'm making a gluten free chocolate chip cookies later.
Okay.
He's just like, oh, no.
Turn the oven on 325.
Can you guys handle the comments here?
I think I have cheese. I'm pretty good.
Okay.
Well, you have to kind of like stuff, and then you comment.
Hey.
All right. My job's done.
Good.
Yo.
Get the sugar and the flour out.
Get Carol's gluten-free flour out. Get the butter out.
Sugar.
Butter's right there.
I need 6 tablespoons. Why, is it hot in here?
It does seem.
There's an option to upload this to YouTube when you guys are done.
Yeah.
Let me adjust this bad boy.
Bruce said, Deb, I see the cheerleaders here. You better hurry.
Oh, all right. I'm coming, Bruce. All right, see you guys.
Bye. So we need 210 grams of Carol's flour. Do you want to weigh that for me? Please, please, please.
Doug, it's your job to be doing this.
Yeah, Doug, what are you doing?
You're the sous chef.
Beach, go move mom's car.
I'm adjusting the temperature.
Where's
the...
He's the more anything, isn't he?
It's going to be great. So. It's going to be great.
It's right in front of you, Doug.
It's a big bag, yeah, that stuff.
How much do we need?
210 grams. And we need, butter. Where's how much butter we need? Oh, did you weigh the eggs in this recipe?
I don't weigh anything, and it turns out great.
If you weighed it, it would turn out even better.
Well, I just didn't weigh anything. Oh. Prue says, Doug,
yo.
Get engaged.
Yeah, Doug.
Thanks, Prue. Oh, get engaged. Right, I got it, man. Whoops.
We need 6
210 over here?
210 over there. We need 6 tablespoons, 84 grams of butter. You're just going to run the scale, I guess. 84 grams of butter. When Doug's on our little show, because then I don't feel so tall, because he's bigger and taller than me, so it's great.
And here's the flour.
Good.
How much butter?
84 grams of butter. 100. Can you do 150 grams of sugar too?
One thing at a time.
It's good to weigh your ingredients when you bake, because baking is actually science.
I have a question. How do you make sugar not crystallize and form into rocks like that? Is there a way?
You just shake it like that.
Wow, 84, that's a lot of butter.
It's all gone.
Well, because I had it in the freezer for a while.
It's a shitload of butter.
And yeah, it's almost a stick.
I made something recently, I think it was after donuts.
Yeah.
Crumb cake. It, like, the whole bag was, like, crystallized. So we sifted it all, and that's what you were left with.
Mm. You shouldn't keep sugar in the freezer.
I know, that's why I moved it to that.
That was smart.
Okay. Boom. There you go. 84.
Thanks.
How much? Right here?
Kylie. Grams.
Okay. See, this I can do all day long.
Yeah. See, this I can do.
What'd you say, 154?
I forgot now. 150.
A little bit of sugar up in here.
So, as I told Kylie, baking is a science. Why don't you come on here with me, brother?
Let me just go get some here and, you know, better than what I'm wearing.
Okay. What, are you wearing just schwundies?
No, I'm wearing shorts, but they're really short.
Sorry, but those are not shorts.
There you go.
Yes, they are.
Okay. Thanks, Doug. Okay, hurry up. So, can you put this, Doug?
How do I pause my gigot here?
You can't pause your gigot. Take it off.
I don't really know how to do this.
This is good. We're getting like a couple steps closer to my brother being able to cook something for me. Just turn it on.
Yeah?
He needs to blow his nose, so he's becoming a bit agitated because he has to blow his nose and doesn't know how to take the mic off. And doesn't really know how to use the mixer. Here. So, when you cream butter and sugar, which is like usually the base for all, for baking anything, is especially sweet stuff, is the butter and sugar gets creamed together first. And the longer you beat it, the more air gets whipped into the butter, and it gets, your butter and your sugar mix can go from yellow to almost white, depending on how long you beat it. And it definitely, it changes the outcome of the texture of what you're making. So I'm just gonna beat that till it's a bit fluffy and combined, and then I'm gonna add, I think I need an egg. Yay. Can you, I need to be able to see that. Do we need one egg?
For the donuts, you need two eggs at room temperature heat. I just won't have my arm tips when that happens.
Do we need anything else measured?
We need this measured.
Huh?
We need this measured.
100 grams.
Of egg?
Yeah.
Well, let me...
No, you gotta beat it first, then measure it.
I just...
Here. Here. So eggs and sugar... Don't bang it against the sides. The eggs and sugar are combined. What's so funny?
Sorry.
Okay, good. Good.
Did you do 6 fluid ounces?
How much weight?
6 fluid ounces of cider, no. But I can just use a measuring cup for that because I think 8 ounces is a cup, right?
What's the weight here that we want?
100.
How many ounces in a cup?
8 ounces in a cup, right?
So you need 3/4 cups. 6 ounces.
Dink?
Yeah.
104, good enough.
Oh, good. So.
But I think that's different for different liquids.
You know, I have a liquid measure.
That's fine.
What, the grammages? You're right, Beesh.
That's 3/4 of a cup, basically. I have a cookbook. I have many cookbooks, but I have a cookbook at home from this bakery and restaurant called Husk in LA. And the girl that wrote the book said in every recipe, she doubles the salt and doubles the vanilla. And I've been doing that ever since. And it's really a good tip because it really makes your stuff better. And I always use salted butter, even though some people say that a lot of bakers say you should use unsalted. I just prefer stuff to be a little bit saltier. Can you get me the cream of tartar?
What's that?
It's just white powder. And I need baking powder too. And baking soda.
Here's your tartar.
Don't you love when your drawer is overloaded and gets stuck?
Love that.
There we go.
That doesn't irritate me. Like ever.
Well, I'd like to say that...
Baking soda, what else?
As a founding member of the Joyce family, that we're not that prone to irritation, so...
We're virtually irritation-proof. Isn't that right, Kyle?
We're virtually irritated 100% of the time.
I cannot be irritated.
That's what we virtually are, is always annoyed. Yeah. God.
Okay. You know what I find makes me, generally disposes me to being irritable? Is the weather. Like when I step outside and it's like 995 trillion degrees out, I'm instantly irritated.
One quarter baking soda.
Roughly? Yeah, roughly.
Did my mom seriously leave her phone?
Oh, no.
That's not going to be good.
I need 1.5 teaspoons baking powder, Doug. Here.
Surprised she's not blowing up my phone right now.
She doesn't know.
Well, she'll blow up, get someone else's phone and blow it up. Yeah, right.
What are you doing?
What do you need?
I need this other shit. What was that? Was that soda or powder?
This is powder, soda.
Oh,
I thought you said you needed some soda.
I thought I effed it. I need 1.5 teaspoons baking powder. Baking powder?
I don't know if we have baking powder.
I have it in my hand.
Oh.
2, 3.
Prue, you should come do a little cameo up in here.
I think she's watching anymore.
Although we'd have to shut off. That's okay. We'd have to shut off the microphones. For sure.
Why would you have to do that?
Because she would blow them out.
Is she loud?
Is she loud? I guess that's what he's saying, is that
she's super loud. Like, you know, we were just at this thing together for a week. And she'd be, like, we'd either be sitting next to each other in a restaurant, or I'd be sitting next to her in a car, and I'm just like, I find myself like inching away from her voice. I'm like, Prue, let's use our whisper voice. actually, yeah. And she's on a scale of 1 to 10, like a speaker volume, she's at like 1.5.
No, don't lay down here.
And I'm like. Yeah.
Can you get Moo Moo out of here?
Hi, Moo.
Oh, you want some
soda bread? Yeah.
So mix the dry ingredients.
Hi, Moo Moo.
You mix the dry ingredients a little bit with your butter.
What are we making here? Donuts?
Yeah, we're making donuts, Doug. Can you give me apple cider? We're just gonna go in there.
Or what am I making?
You're just measuring. Can
what
you,
else do we need? Oh.
I need apple cider. Mm. Egg's got to go in.
No.
All right, we're done with the butter. I'm going to put it away.
Good thing about using gluten-free flour in lieu of any other flour is that gluten-free flour doesn't develop gluten. And so you can't overmix it. Gluten flour you can overmix.
Yep.
And then you basically turn your donuts into bread. Nobody likes chewy donuts.
Nope. Don't like chewy donuts up in here.
So, although gluten-free flour can sometimes have a reputation for not being as good.
Sometimes. It's just what you're used to.
That's true. So, did I get it all in? Baking powder, baking soda, salt, cream of tartar, cinnamon. Ooh, nutmeg. I need nutmeg. Do you guys have fresh nutmeg, or what do you use, Kylie?
I just use the nutmeg that's in there. It's in a little, it's like a short little one.
Kai, those raisins are a critical component for the soda bread.
So if you want to change your baking life and your results, I would advise switching to fresh nutmeg. It actually looks like an acorn, and it comes in a little, you can buy like a few of them, and you use a little microplane and you grate it, and it was like, it's life-changing. It smells totally different than the stuff that's ground in the container.
What's happening over there at the zoo?
They're trying to get to the eggs.
Trying to get to what eggs?
Whose eggs?
Well, why don't you move them out of here and the dogs will follow?
Why don't you not try to keep the dogs away from Boo?
What?
Try to keep the dogs away from Boo.
Well, that's not going to happen.
She'll keep them away.
No, they won't. She's going to start
snoring. So, where is your donut pan?
That's that drawer right there, middle.
Will you get it for me, Dad?
So, Chef. Yes, Chef.
No, I don't think so.
All right, well, that's here.
I think it's over here. Like this? Is that what you're talking about? One of these puppies?
No, it's like a little bunt pan looking thing.
Check in the drawer, bottom drawer. Sarah moves in.
What's it look like?
It looks like a donut.
Looks like there's donuts.
Oh, this here?
Yeah. Bow chicka wow wow. It's not actually a donut pan, but it works. Another trick to using Pam in your kitchen is spray over the sink. Because if you get overspray on anything, it's in the sink and not on your counter or on your floor.
Yeah.
Which makes everything at first really slippery and then sticky. Spray your in-betweeners in case you have overflow. Because if you overflow, it sticks and you can't get it out.
That's right.
It's great to have a dog right in your way. Want to pick her up?
Moomoos, get out of here.
She's so annoying.
She's desperate.
Let's go.
She's desperate for anything.
Takes care of that.
Mm-hmm. You know what Debbie never has is a...
A special. Yeah, yeah. We do have a special.
Madeline had a bunch in her... No. When she was in her baking phase. But then they pretty much
that'll work.
Got trashed.
Check in that drawer.
This one?
Yeah.
They got
bingo.
Oh yeah. They got trashed?
No, Doug's talking about the icing
Yeah.
Bingo bongo.
Yeah.
Madeline was in a baking phase?
Like years ago, yeah. She wanted to make cakes and she wanted to be a baker.
So she bought this decorating kit. Well, you know, one of the guys that I was at this thing with, Bo.
Yeah.
He's like a master cake baker dude.
Yeah.
And he literally has like a million people following him on his Facebook, even still.
But he
isn't,
still what?
Isn't doing it anymore.
Oh, really?
He used to bake cakes. Like, people would pay him, like, $800,000, $900,000 to bake a cake. And he would do, like, it was, like, amazing.
$900,000?
No, $900,000/$1,000.
Oh, I was like,
bake a cake.
Wow.
But he was, like...
You mean wedding cakes?
All kinds of cakes. Birthday cakes, like, cakes for Geico.
Wow, he was
like,
good.
He had, like, a legit... like, a legit...
What happened there?
Like a legit following. And he still has it now, but he's like, meh, he doesn't want to do it. But he can't shake it. Anyway, it's pretty...
He doesn't want to bake cakes anymore?
No, he used to have these classes and people would come to his class and he'd make a ton of money teaching women how to bake cakes and decorate them and all that stuff.
Wow.
Yeah, he was in New York.
Yeah. Well... I just can't imagine anyone in Clearwater paying any money to learn how to bake cakes.
No, not in Clearwater. Not in CW.
You know, you'd have to like be somewhere where the demographic was somewhat different.
Not here. That's definitely a New York demographic.
Yeah.
Like all day.
I mean,
long.
I would love to go to that class myself.
Yeah.
But I definitely wouldn't want to make cakes for a living.
No. No, he did it. He said... You know, the money, the real money was in the training. Because yeah. He'd have like, you know, 15, 20 people come to his class, I guess, and charge them, I don't know, a couple $100, I guess, a pop.
Yeah.
That's better than spending all weekend, 48 hours, making, I don't know, 5 cakes for 2 G's.
We got one viewer, guys.
Woo!
Who is it?
Probably
Debbie. No
idea.
You can see who it
Debbie.
Is.
She ain't got a phone.
Ow.
Oh, you're great.
Okay.
We still prove.
Boom.
They're going in.
There it is.
Apple cider donuts.
Do you
want to
move it underneath that thing right now?
Yeah.
Underneath.
There
you
go. Where's Sue? Did you tell Sue about this?
All right, it's going in the oven.
Okay.
Sue's in treason because she's not watching.
Maybe we'll come back when we're done. These are only going to take like probably 10 minutes. So we don't bore you.
Are you not going to make the gluten-free soda bread?
No.
It's more of a process.
Honestly, you should just make another batch of them because that's never enough for both houses.
That would have been good to suggest in the beginning of the process, and I could have doubled the recipe. But now I'm done. Well, next time.
Continue. That's fine.
Thanks for the suggestion.
All right,
I think we're done.
Next time.
See y'all, and remember, if you need your Feminescence Macapaws, this is the stuff right here. As the
Doug
husband,
takes it.
Doug would know.
As the husband, Doug would know. Thank you very much. Because as my wife goes through menopause, I'm essentially having menopause myself.
Oh,
menopause.
Menopause. Yeah. Any brothers out there know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, bro.
It's true.
All right.
So there you go.
Okay. We'll come back and show you the final product in 10 minutes.
Sayonara, say bye.
Toodaloo.